The Speaker's directive quashed the earlier recommendation made by Amos Kankunda, the chairperson Parliament's Finance Committee, who urged Parliament to approve the Ministry of Finance's proposal that sought to increase the minimum paid-up cash capital requirements for microfinance deposit-taking institutions from 500 million shillings to 10 billion shillings. The committee argued that the value of the required minimum capital requirements has been eroded over time and needs to be aligned with the macroeconomic developments.
If in 2003, the minimum capital under tier three was 500 million, now, 20 years down the road, we are proposing to take it 10 billion. Under tier two, if in 2003, we were at 1 billion, now the minimum capital required here is 25 billion. For tier one banks, in 2003, we are at 25 billion. Now we are at 150 billion.
However, Mwanga Chivombi, the Butambala County MP, who authored a minority report, asked Parliament to reject the recommendations made in the majority report, arguing that such a move may also pose challenges in terms of lending capacity, growth for smaller microfinance deposit-taking institutions, and financial inclusion.
When you do this kind of thinking by the World Bank institutions, what has happened is that the local players are being crowded out of the financial market.
Because they cannot raise the money, required. Capital.
Therefore, as we legislate, that's why I made a question of capital flight. And I said, as long as those that earn profit at the end of the day in the bank are foreign, consequently, there is no trickle down to the people in the rural areas.
What is the percentage of what you can lend out vis-a-vis how much money you can keep as cash to maintain liquidity in the bank? And it is also based on how much security or how secured are your depositors and borrowers.
MPs across the political divide were persuaded by the minority report, noting that increasing cash capital requirements of microfinance deposit-taking institutions is another way of kicking Ugandans out of the banking business for foreigners.
Microfinance deposit-taking institutions are the ones which are easily accessible by our rural people. We already have a bad precedent in this country. The cost of credit is very high. If we make the capital requirement very high, we shall be closing out more new players. If we allow new players to come into the market, we shall create the cost of credit lower because of competition. I don't agree with the majority report, and I wish to adopt the minority report.
If you look at 360 degrees, why the financial sector is struggling is because its savings is not mobilized properly. So encouraging microfinance to go rural in a liberal manner will mobilize out savings and grow the economy and bring down interest rates. Did we go to the same school of economics? Did we do the same economics, Honourable Minister?
In this regard, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, acknowledged the problem and sent the instrument back to the Committee of Finance with a directive to the committee to engage more stakeholders.
FINCA was not consulted. The stakeholders were not consulted. I am going to defer this and the committee goes back to consult.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.